How's it going? Scott Devine here for scottsbasslessons.com, and today we're going to be looking at the top 10 slap bass lines ever created through time. And I'm also going to be looking at the development of slap bass as well as it goes through the years and moves from player to player. So without further ado, let's get into it. So first up, we've got the godfather of slap bass, Larry Graham, with Sly and the Family Stone, 1970 this was. And it's thank you for letting me be myself again. This is the first track ever, apparently, that had slap bass on it. Let's check it out and then we'll get into it. It's kind of... it's definitely not what you see nowadays. But Larry does that now. Like, he's changed as well over the years, but it's great to see where it all began. And the pop for Larry in this era is actually pulling the string. Now check out this. This is Larry many years later playing the same bass line, but you'll see how his style has changed throughout the years. Check it out. Now one thing you'll see here as well, one of the other guys will be focusing on, Larry sometimes uses his thumb to fret notes down here as well and then has it over the top of the fingerboard. One of the bass players we'll be looking at in a few tracks time does exactly the same kind of thing. Might have played bass for Michael Jackson? Let me know in the comments if you can guess, but do not fast forward. Now the next riff I want to point out is actually also from Larry Graham and is called Hair in his band Graham Central Station. You can hear how Larry's style developed from where it was, you know, only a few years ago. This is like 1974, this one. You know, the... on this, well, just let him do his thing. Check this out. So good, right? Now, I play it completely different to Larry. Larry's got an extremely heavy thumb when he's playing this riff, where I'm kind of a little more delicate, so... whereas Larry, let's just check this out. Just look at how hard he's hitting it. This is all thumb, right? It's got this constant, you know, real heavy, just like loads of just power, really aggressive. So next up, we've got Michael Jackson and the amazing Louis Johnson on bass. 1979, Get On The Floor. Just check out this. As I was beavering around the internet, I found this, which is Louis Johnson demoing the line, but as he's doing it, he's actually doing it in, I think, he does it in A. When you watch him, just check it out. He's got that Larry Graham over the top of the fingerboard thing going on with his left hand as well. Super cool. Check it out. Remember, Larry's not really doing that. He's playing through the string. He's playing through the string, almost like using a plectrum, right? But Lewis, he was definitely, he was using the bounce. Now in 1980, the Brothers Johnson released Stomp. And this is where you can really see the Louis Johnson style developing. It sounds so, so good. Check this out. And he's really happy. Look how happy he is. Oh, so good. Check this out. This is really the first time as well that we're hearing this, you know, like left hand percussion coming in. So this line specifically is in G and he's holding that G down, okay, and then using the rest of his fingers. Okay. Now, next up, we've got Marcus Miller, one of the most important bass players in the development of slap bass. And this track is Run for Cover by David Sanborn, and I think it's 1981. So the year after you've just watched Lewis Johnson with Stomp. I would say that Marcus's style is much more refined, okay? It's more refined and not as aggressive. He's definitely not doing the Lewis thing where his hands traveling like more than a foot off the instrument. Check this out and you'll get what I mean. Now you can even see that like this here is about as far as his thumb ever travels from the bass. If we all think about the modern day slap tone, right? What do people sound like when they slap, you know, had that mid scoopy thing? This was really for me when that was born, 1981 with Marcus Miller playing with Sanborn. Before I move on, that thing here, that line, I see so many people playing that wrong. I almost start up with it up bent already. So I'm not doing this. I'm not doing that, I'm going. And then the other one, that thing there, he's actually sliding it. Check it. So in 1981, over the pond here in the UK, we had a young lad called Mark King, who was doing his own thing with a band called Level 42. They were huge here. What I think about Mark's style is it's much more Lewis Johnson than it is Marcus Miller. If we look at Johnson, like later on, I've got this great video actually here. It's not exactly the same as Mark King, but I find there's more synergy between those guys than Marcus. I think Marcus was really doing his own thing, even though he did, you know, take influences from them. And harmonically as well, probably more advanced as well, coming from the background that he did. Now next up we've got the amazing Freddie Washington, 1982, playing with Patrice Rushen on her track Forget Me Nots. This was again just like a revolutionary move in terms of slap bass, because if anybody says, I wonder what P bass sounds like, slapped. Sounds like that. Now, I've actually got Freddie doing this live here on this video. And the reason why I wanted to pull this up is because Freddie plays all of those notes with his thumb for the most part, which is like some kind of sort of, I don't know, like ingenious. Like all of this is cool. He's not hammering it on, is he? Check Freddie out, it's crazy. There we go. So relaxed. Here we go. He plays it all with his thumb. I need to get in the shed. Okay, so next up we've got Flea, obviously with the Red Hot Chili Peppers, and it is 1989. They released that track, Higher Ground, obviously originally written by Stevie Wonder. Check him out playing Higher Ground. It's really just a killer. Now, a couple of things to point out, and I might be wrong, so please let me know if you saw somebody doing this before Flea, but Flea, for me, was the first guy that was doing the downward thumb thing. But the issue with down thumb, here's the issue, is that you can't do a lot of the stuff that you can do when you're doing double thumbing, where you play through and up like this, so down and up, using your thumb like a plectrum. A lot of that stuff you can't do when you're playing down thumb. So it's worth experimenting with both techniques. If it was me, I'd probably go back, if I could go back in time, I'd be like, Scott, do the up thumb thing. So next, we're in 1992, bass player Tim Comerford, band Rage Against the Machine, track Take the Power Back. It was a huge thing when I heard this, you know, people were freaking out about it. Let's check it out. So good, right? Really, really good. And if you're trying to play that tune as well, remember, you've got to tune your lower E string to D. Tim was another, he's another down thumber. It might be that these guys are like more, they've got the straps lower, they're, you know, they're more rock. So maybe that is where that downward thumb and slap bass was born from back in the day. So last but not least, we have got the mighty Victor Wooten and his track Classical Thumb. I want you to look out for what's called double thumbing. If you look at his thumb and it looks like he's doing half the work, it's because when he goes down, he also plucks the string going up as well. So he's getting two for the price of one. And that ties all the way back to the first guy that we watched today, Larry Graham. I'm gonna show you Victor Wooten talking in 1 second about that relationship and how it all ties together. But check this out. So good. But check out this. This is Victor talking about where this idea came from, the double thumb. It was actually from his brother, Reggie. Check this out.
Larry Graham, I learned how to just go. Right? Step. Right? But he would just lay right on that one. And I was like, man. And I tell you, here's a little thing that people don't know about me anyway. It was that one note groove that started me going down and up with my thumb. Because as a kid, I could not get that right bounce. I didn't have it. It was, you know, it's not straight. It's, you know, it's got pulse in it. So Reggie started saying, well, why don't you try going down and up with your thumb? And he started teaching me to do it that way. And that was the start of everything. It actually came from Larry Graham.
If you think about Detroit by Marcus Miller, that thing is like using the up thumbing, you know? And if we look at his track, this guy's awesome. That, Google. I'd love to know if other people using it came directly from Victor Wooten. So I'd love for you guys to let me know in the comments if you do have like the definitive evidence that states this is the linear line that went through slap bass. But hopefully this video was, you know, good to watch and gave you an idea, broad brushstrokes of how it has evolved all the way from, you know, late 60s, 70, all the way through to today. And while you're commenting down below, make sure you hit like and subscribe to this channel as well. Go check out scottsbasslessons.com. It's the ultimate online bass school for bass players such as yourself, so you can learn from the best bass players on the planet from the comfort of your own home. And you can grab a 14-day free trial as well. Anyway, as always, take it easy and I'll see you in the shed.